We did two videos, actually. We were kind of annoyed by Premiere. You might remember, MP had a breakdown. We just get used to it. And then we started using Resolve a couple of months ago. And then we released a video called We Can't Work Like This. MP and I edited on a documentation that we've been working on, and we tested the DaVinci Resolve Speed Editor, and I love it. And he will show you in this video what's it all about. And MP is the fastest one using this one. Are you actually faster, Jan? Or is MP faster? MP is the fastest one. The Speed Editor, MP himself.
Turn up. I wish you would. Pinocchio, tell me what's good. Would you tell me what's good, or do you need time in a clear view, a clear mind, clear eyes? Ben Stein, you know that old guy from like 05 with that tagline.
What's up, guys? This is MP, and I want to personally welcome you here into my editing space. Thank you so much, Christoph. And yeah, as Christoph said, today we are talking about the Resolve Speed Editor. So this is a very interesting tool which currently comes actually free to any Resolve license that you buy. So I think it's about it must be around 300 euros here in Germany. So if you buy a Resolve license, Resolve 17, you will get the Speed Editor for free, which is very nice. And well, we thought, all right, let's check it out. Today is about the Speed Editor, and I have to say it's nice. The whole purpose of it is, as you can tell by the name, to edit with speed, to be fast at editing. If you are familiar with a cut page in Resolve, which I wasn't actually, this is perfect for you. The Speed Editor performs on the cut page at its highest potential, because you have all the buttons that are basically made for the cut page, you know? So this thing was designed to use the cut page. You can still use it in the edit page, but the edit page is more like the small details at the end of a project when you're just finishing it up. You can do the rough edit of a project completely in the cut page and be fast with the speed editor. So I found it the most useful for just selecting images from a bin. You have a bin full of videos from a whole day of shooting, maybe multiple cameras even, and you can use the speed editor to scroll through all the videos at a very fast pace and select the clips that you want to use and the in and out points and just pull clips into your timeline. I think it's hard to explain, so maybe I'm going to show you just a few glimpses in a Resolve project and how you can use this. I won't tell you every button because I actually don't even know myself yet, but I just want to share like my experience with it, if it's worth buying for you, or if you may be good on mouse and keyboard, because I thought like I'm very fast on mouse and keyboard and editing because I've done that for years. I never worked on a dedicated keyboard, and with the speed editor I feel like for now I'm a bit slower actually, because I have to learn how it's working, how it's performing in the timeline. But I think if you're really spending time using the speed editor, you eventually will get very fast with editing and also with your rough cut, which is like the most important and maybe even the longest part of your edit. If you have like 20 hours of footage, you have to go through that, right? So I think I talked enough now, and I think we should go into the Resolve software to show you guys a few things that might be useful for it. So now we're inside DaVinci Resolve 17, as you can see. I'm already in the cut page, and I've imported some footage from our 2019 trip to New York, some B-roll, which is quite nice. I think we can work with that, some sample red footage. So right now I have a clip selected, our first clip, but we can also select this one, our source tape. We can click on this, and you can see we have now all clips in like one smaller timeline, and you can see the marker right here telling you when there's a new clip starting. I have my Resolve Speed Editor right here. I'm going to show you some of the basic functions first. So we have the jog wheel. As you can see, we can scroll through our footage, but this is quite slow, right? So we have the jog option and the scroll option. With scroll we can go way faster through our footage and way less in the detail. And if we, like, for example, find a clip that we find nice, let's see what we have here. Yeah, the reflections are nice. We can go into the jog mode and be like way more precise about where we're gonna start our clip. So let's say I just wanna go set our endpoint here right before those reflections are starting. I just need to click the in button right here. We have our in and out points here. This is also the trimming part where you can like trim clips. I will show you that later. Here on the top, we have our insert section, and this section is for multicam, but it has some nice secondary features. I will talk about that later. Let's see, we click stop and play right here, and we will stop our clip right here. Now we have a selection, and we can just insert it into our timeline using the smart insert button right here. One tap and boom, it's in our timeline. Let's go ahead and select another clip just so I can show you all the features. I really like those red lights right here. Let's see where we have a nice shot. Maybe just in the beginning. I'm going to the jog mode so I can be more precise. Setting my in point right before that is starting, right here, in here, and out here. Insert, boom, in our timeline. Next clip. Oh, this man is nice. It's a nice employee from Madame Tussauds. So, let's see. I like his smile here, so let's just put our endpoint here. Very nice man, and put our outpoint right here and insert. So next clip, what else do we have? This is a very nice shot. I really love this. Gives you kind of those Broadway vibes. So let's see, maybe we go in here and go out here. Now, if we want to place this clip on top of our other clips, let's say maybe here in our timeline on top, we can just do that by pushing the place on top button, obviously. So if I click that now, you can see it placed the selection on top. But actually, it placed the whole clip on top. Okay, interesting. Didn't know that. So that's a great possibility now to show you guys the trim feature. So obviously he put the whole clip in it, so now I can use the trim out button. I'm gonna press this and can just trim our out point right here. So we go here, and then we can trim our in point as well. So now you may ask yourself, how does Resurf know which clip I want to trim, like on which track? There is a function with a multicam buttons right here. So those have secondary functions because I don't do multicam edits like all the time. You can just press cam 2 and take a look at the track section. Boom, I'm on track 2. Track 1, track 2. So this is actually a track selection, which is very nice because now I can say I'm on track 2, I want to trim this clip, trim in, and go ahead and trim it. And I think this is very fast. So what you will see now, I'm going to trim it, and I have my clip back here, but it's like way on the end of the timeline, but we want to have it at the beginning. So now I can do the secondary function of roll, which is slide. Double press it, and I can go ahead and slide the clip all the way to the front where I wanna have it. Perfect. So you already get a kind of a glimpse of what this is all about and how you can like be really fast if you like practice this speed editor a lot. If you practice it, you will be, I guess, in a few weeks, you will be the fastest editor among your friends and colleagues. Yeah, this is very nice. Let me think, what else can I show you? You have some functions here, like for cut and dissolve transitions, like for, if I press dissolve, and this will place like a dissolve transition right on these two clips. If I now want to change the length, because I think like, ooh, this is maybe a bit slow, I can just do so by holding down the transition duration button and just change this right here. Another feature which is very nice is if you want to change the clip itself but keep the length of it, you can do so by using the slip source button. If I press this, you can see now I'm changing the the clip without changing its length. And if you work like this and like get used to it, I think you will be very fast in like a few days or weeks. I don't know how I did, but I just edit a split right here, and I don't want that. You can use the secondary function of escape, which is undo, double press it, bam, and the split is removed. So I just want to give you an overview of what is possible right here. I don't want to show you every button because there are a lot more buttons that I could talk about. For example, you have the snap button to snap, activate the snap function. You have the split, the ripple delete. If I want to delete this clip, ripple delete and it's gone. All those functions, there's a lot to learn right here. But I just want to give you an overview of what this is capable of, and so that you get a feeling if this is right for you or not. Yeah, I hope that you got like a small glimpse of the speed editor and what it's capable of. And if you want to have like a full in-depth review, I will be happy, or we will be happy, to show that to you. Just let us know in the comments so we know that you guys are interested in that. I would be super happy if you do so and leave some feedback here, because this is actually also for me, it's quite a challenge to record a video, because I'm normally more behind the camera. So that's all about the DaVinci Resolve Speed Editor, a little handy device which might help you fasten up your edit. And yeah, as I said before, I think this is for people who are using the cut timeline a lot, or would like to like dive into the cut timeline more, because I think I didn't like it at first because it was like a basic resolve, like an entry level resolve. But I now get the point of the cut timeline. The cut timeline is to sort your footage, to go through it, to select clips, and just to get that rough cut done. And this is perfect in the cut page, and the speed editor helps immensely with it. So should you buy it? Well, if you don't already have a Resolve license, you need to get a Resolve license, Resolve Studio, and it's free with it. Maybe you find a good deal online, because some people just want the license and some people just want the speed editor, so they are selling either the license or the speed editor. I think you can find a good deal there if you don't want both. But if you want both, this is the perfect time now to go and buy a Resolve license to get the speed editor. Yeah, thank you so much. I hope I gave you a little bit of a good glimpse into the speed editor and how I am planning on using it, because as you saw, I'm actually not the fastest with it yet, but I'm learning, we're all learning, and I guess this is what it's all about. So guys, make sure you subscribe to this channel right here and watch maybe our video why we switched to Resolve down here. And if you want, you can join our Discord server, which we are currently working on, because we have to figure out how to get a bit interaction there and how to like meet your guys' needs there. So if you want to join our Discord server, do it here. All right, take care, guys.